Our ancestors are from Macedonia, Greece.
Wow. This is spectacular.
Go. I don't think you understand the sacrifices that I make.
Hey, Johnny!
Thank you, sir.
Bye-bye. Okay, off to the mountains. Karakoram Mountains, part of the greater Himalayan range. So we're gonna take a flight, an hour flight, and then a bit of a road trip to get up. Oh, over there? Okay. To get up into some of the biggest peaks in the world.
أنت الصاحب في السفر والخلق.
Here we are, Gilgit. Just flew over the Hindu Kush range into the valley here. I believe this is Hunza Valley. And then taking a bus up away into the valley.
Assalamu alaikum.
And Maksud picked me up at the airport. I don't really know how this is playing out. I think I'm getting a bus. A bus, yeah? Bus?
Bus, when?
Hunza Valley?
When, going.
And he brought me to a place to buy a coat and then found me the transport to Karimabad. Assalamu alaikum. This is the journey, this is the van. We ready? Get inside.
Give me money.
Give you money. No money, no honey.
Karimabad.
Here we are. It's one big family now, right, Yagat? Yeah. Quite beautiful scenery. Look at this. 2 hours up to Hunza Valley. To Hunza. I'm so close to the camera because I have no options. Okay, we've been stopping every little bit here and it's just got really tight. Yeah?
That big one.
Can you help me?
Yeah, I just gotta get my hip out of the door hinge. We just got another guy in the van. Guy in front of me thinks this is quite funny. Absolutely massive peaks kicking out of this town. I don't even know where we are. The van dropped, and yes, now we're going.
Adiabad. This is
Adiabad.
Yes.
You have blue eyes.
Yes, sir.
Blue eyes. Same. It's normal up here.
Yes, normal blue eyes, sir. I am Hunza people, sir.
Hunza people.
Yes, see here.
So sometimes it doesn't always work out, and the place I checked into didn't have heat. You can see by what I'm wearing, you definitely want some heat. No, I found a little piece of heaven here. Thank you. Can I show the video of this place?
Yeah, sure.
Thank you. Your name?
Aftab.
So you're saying everyone's mixed up up here, obviously, yeah. As we can see in the camera.
Yeah.
So where's this guy from? Where do you think he's from?
Russia.
He's Russian?
Australian?
This guy's Australian with a W.
Yeah.
He's like more like a Central Asian.
From Tashkent, Uzbekistan.
Yeah. With small eyes.
And you?
From Pakistan.
So this is normal up here in Hunza. Everyone's mixed.
Everyone is mixed.
But usually when you get to small, remote mountain regions, mm-hmm. there's sort of like one look. But here it's
maybe
not like
here
that.
There are different races.
Yeah. Do you own this cool cafe?
Yeah, I do own it.
And you were telling me, this is a hard one to believe. How much do you pay in taxes?
Zero. We don't have any taxes here.
That's fantastic. You're the envy of many people. Yeah. It's got some good style, too. And look at this view.
and then add to this beauty. What a terrace.
I am super pumped to be in this air, this fresh mountain scenery, and out of the cities. The owner here wanted $100 a night. I gave him the lowball price and it went down to 50 very quickly. I don't think anyone's staying here at the moment. But they have heat, which is a nice addition. Cool, simple, clean room. That's all I need. Gonna get some solid sleep tonight. And we're gonna get out there into Hunza. It's a wild place that's got a lot going on. Culturally, geographically, historically. Okay, here we are. Day one, full day one. Fahim. Fahim.
Namaste.
Karim.
Kalim.
Kalim. And we're going, where are we going, guys?
We are going to Baltic Fort.
Baltic Fort.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. So some Balti artisans, people from Skardo came and, you know, introduced these kinds of buildings here.
So the traditional Hunzai architecture,
yeah,
right?
Somehow it looks like this. This place was basically the winter capital of the king of Hunza.
Uh-huh.
The summer capital was Golmet, which is my village, and the upper Hunza.
So, near China, right? It's pretty close to China.
Yeah, it's really close to China.
So that has like a Tibetan look to it, doesn't
yeah.
it?
Yeah. Sort of? So it is the Tibetan architecture, the Balti architects.
Assalamu alaikum. Assalamu alaikum.
How are you, sir?
Yeah, good, sir.
What's your name?
Peter.
Peter.
Yeah.
You're from USA?
Yeah.
Oh, nice.
And you? What's your name?
My name's Asif.
Asif. You're from Hunza.
Nice to meet you. Yeah, Karimabad.
Man, do many people have red hair like you up here?
Yeah, it is really usual here. Our ancestors are from Macedonia, Greece.
Alexander the Great.
Yeah.
You look a little bit like him, I think.
Oh,
you look like
maybe Alexander. He's your...
I don't know Alexander, actually.
He's in your blood, man. This is one of the coolest parts of the world I've seen.
Oh, thank you. Very
because,
much.
Okay, the geography.
Yeah.
And then the mix of people.
Yeah.
Like, it's all mixed up. Yeah. And it's educated. Like, people are educated here.
Yeah, yeah.
Are you married?
No. I just turned 35.
Nobody's married, right?
That's
again, this is really interesting.
Yeah.
Usually when you go into the countryside, right, out in the middle of nowhere, everyone's married. And the guys here seem to have no interest in getting married.
Thank you.
Bye-bye.
Thank you for being here. Thank you. It's Pakistan special.
Thank you, brother.
Brother.
You guys are cool. You guys are so cool.
You are also very cool.
You guys are very welcoming, very friendly.
Thank you.
Big hearts.
Yeah. Big mountains, big hearts.
This is the sacred rocks of Hunza. We have two sacred rocks here. There are some ancient scriptures. Buddhist pilgrimage basically visited this place and went down to Swat, Rawalpindi and this side. So this was the route.
Buddhism was here before Islam.
Yeah, Buddhism was here.
It gets more beautiful up the valley.
Yeah.
So what's going on here?
So welcome to Atabad Lake. This is an artificial lake formed in 2010 due to a landslide. You can see that part.
Over here?
Yeah, over okay. there. Okay. So it slipped into the river and blocked it, so this artificial lake was formed. And due to this, the road was gone, the road went in the river.
Okay.
And
but your friends helped out here.
And here are friends.
Long live the Pak-China friendship.
Pakistan, Zindabad.
Three tunnels, right?
Yeah, three. There are five, four tunnels.
Okay.
Five, something like that. So they built this tunnel for us because there was no road at that time.
Because this is one of the biggest routes, the Karakoram Highway is one of the biggest routes out of China, right?
Yeah.
Like into Pakistan.
This is the only road to China.
Part of the One Belt.
Yeah, it's a part of the One Road, One Belt initiative. So the old Silk Road basically passed from this area. It connected this region with Central Asia and China.
So this is the new Silk Road.
Yeah, so this is the new Silk Road.
The Chinese are setting up the infrastructure of the world, huh?
Yeah, that's what they're doing. And they're going to dominate, yes!
But it's only about friendship.
Yeah,
just so you know.
China is our closest friend.
This is true?
Yeah, it is true.
All your friends are from China?
I know nobody from China.
You guys are professionals here. Yeah.
My sister-in-law, Saira.
Assalamu alaikum, Saira. So you guys built this place?
Yeah, we built it by ourselves.
Dat Ali, what are you cooking there?
Dam gosh.
Is this an autonomous region?
Yeah, it is an autonomous region. Constitutionally, it's not a part of Pakistan.
So you don't feel connected with the rest of Pakistan?
We are connected in different ways to Pakistan. Uh-huh. Like everything comes from Pakistan.
Sure.
Our food and everything. We go to the cities, the Pakistani cities, and we study there. We feel connected. Mm-hmm. But at the same time, we don't have that representation. In the National Assembly,
okay.
That matters a lot.
Right.
Because if you have a representative there, then you can do a lot of work here. So the cool thing about Gilgit-Baltistan is that the landscape changes after 4 kilometers. And same is the case with the languages and you know everything, ethnicity or whatever you call it. Like in 45 minutes, we were in Center Hunza.
Mm-hmm.
So they speak Brushiski. Now after 45 minutes we drove to Gulmit. Now the people are speaking Wahi. It's the diversity that makes everything cool and beautiful here. That's what I think.
No, I don't think she understands the sacrifices that I made. Maybe if this bitch attacked her right, I would have stayed, but only wasted over half my life. I'm no longer standing. Now I respect that demand. I'm gonna take control of this relationship, command it. Now I'm gonna be the boss of you, not you, goddammit.
It has a smoky.
It's yak meat, right?
Yeah, yak meat.
Some peppers, tomatoes?
Yeah, tomatoes, onion, and with some spices.
Yaks basically eat herbs and flowers.
Okay.
They don't eat the normal grass.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
So a lot of good nutrients in here.
Yeah.
So here's a question I have for you. I think every Westerner has is in Pakistan dangerous? Right, like isn't it full of Taliban and fundamentalist dudes that want to blow things up?
Mm-hmm.
What's your response to that?
I haven't seen Taliban in my life, although I've roamed a lot in Pakistan.
Yeah.
So I haven't met a Taliban yet. Maybe I'm the only Taliban here.
Maybe I'm Taliban.
Yeah, maybe you are the Taliban.
I work for the ISI, do you know that?
Yeah, maybe. Who knows, I might work for them.
I think you do, because uh-huh. You picked me up.
Yeah.
Like, it's super safe here, right? There's not much crime?
It is super safe.
In Hunza?
Yeah, in Hunza. The crime rate is zero and...
Is zero?
Yeah, by zero.
There's got to be something happening.
Yeah, something. Like somebody is, you know, arrested for alcohol.
Mm.
For producing alcohol. or for carrying alcohol and things like that. Those gotcha. Little, small little cases.
Mm-hmm. Yakni is very good.
Yeah, this is.
This is tasty.
Good. Yeah.
So you get these beautiful colors, and it's famous for the trout.
Mm-hmm.
Trout fish.
What is this, you guys?
Turn on the camera.
What is this?
We are going to a university. This is called University of Lahore.
University of Lahore, okay. Let's go. Assalamu alaikum.
Meet our elders
the university.
From the village.
Hello.
Peter?
How are you?
Good, you?
Bakker.
Bakker?
Yes.
Hello, how are you?
Good.
How are you?
Good, thank you.
The tribesman. And he's also the tribesman.
The tribesman?
Yeah, yeah.
So these guys are in charge of the...
The families.
Wow.
So there are different families, 6 to 8 families in this village.
So what do you mean by the university?
I don't know. Why is this called university?
This is the PhD in cards?
Yeah, this is the PhD in cards.
This is also a student.
Yes.
This one is Michael.
Michael,
Vice Chancellor. Michael, come here.
Okay, so this is the university where all the elders hang out.
Yeah.
Good time.
So in the winters, this is one of the good activities here.
Okay.
No, this is the only activity.
It's a men's club. No
women
allowed.
It's a
men's
club. Yeah, it's a men's club.
Where are we going now?
So this is a carpet palace.
Okay. Assalamu alaikum. Assalamu alaikum.
Assalamu
alaikum. How long does it take
4 months
to make one of these? Four months.
So their basic income comes from this,
mm-hmm.
from this weaving thing.
Gotcha.
They support their families, and yeah, they're used to it now.
Gotcha.
If they don't do it, they don't feel relaxed. Mm. So the design comes from these patterns.
Okay. Who makes the design patterns?
Well, they are designers themselves. They design it, and then they complete
okay.
it, yeah. It also comes from Central Asia, like Iran.
Right.
These old thing. Yeah, they preserve the art, in a way.
Yeah.
Most of the women and the men, they have left, you know, everything from their culture, and they now go and do jobs in big cities. But these are the ladies who preserve the culture, the tradition, and the art. That makes them the coolest people in Gulmet.
The coolest ladies in
yeah.
Hunza.
Yeah.
Who's God here?
Huh?
Who is God?
So he wrote something very boring here, and I suggested, so he was asking me for suggestions.
Yeah.
It, what should I write in? So I was kidding, and I said, you should write God on it. And he went to Central Hunza and wrote God on it.
Hey, Johnny, Johnny, I should lay Lia to Yakube Paria to Lunagde Saria to.
The most thing I like here in Hunza, we have organic food.
Yeah, the food is fantastic. I had yak last night.
Yak meat, or
very tasty.
You can say the vegetables,
yeah.
The dry fruit.
Mm-hmm.
Things are organic.
And it's unbelievable that so many people speak English, especially you. Like you're not young anymore, right? You're an older guy, and you speak English very well.
The Hunza people prefer education.
Yeah.
So they send their kids and their children to the schools.
Another cool component to this culture is they don't rip you off when they can. So this morning I was on a shared taxi, and I gave the guy 100 rupees. That's how much I thought it was. And he gave me back, what did he give me back? He gave me back like 65 or something. So many parts of the world, if they can take advantage of you, they will. Like, because you're an outsider, you just don't know. But here, none of that, which is very refreshing. You don't feel like you have to battle everything or bargain everything or you're getting ripped off, which is quite pleasant. Okay, we're gonna go up and get a sweet view of this place. Cool, look at these little doors. The people aren't that tall here, but I guess they were really short back in the day, as you can see. Wow. There's another door. So as you can imagine, these are very tight-knit communities where everybody knows everybody. What's your name?
Soram.
Soram, you live up here?
Yeah, here. Actually, my house is down here and my fields are up here and I was working in my fields.
Okay. So you have a lot of tourists here or no?
Nowadays, not much. But before 9/11, yeah, we used to have a lot of tourists here.
Wow, and still they're scared to come here.
Yep. You are from USA and you know about the media.
Of course.
What kind of image Pakistan have?
Terrible one.
Yeah.
It shows that everyone's a terrorist and you're all Taliban.
Nope.
Unfortunately. But that's why I make these videos.
Oh.
To show the cool people like you.
Thank you.
So thank you. You guys have been awesome up here.
Thank you.
Like the people, the people above been very hospitable, inviting, warm.
Mm-hmm.
And I can say it's like a very peaceful feel.
Yeah, it's peaceful.
Even at the worst,
mm-hmm.
when 9/11 happened,
uh-huh.
and say Pakistan was in its worst position, like 2005, 2006, right?
Yep.
But the Taliban never made it into this valley.
Yeah,
they never even came here.
Yeah, they never met. Actually, they were in Khyber Pakhtunkhwa, KPK,
mm-hmm.
province where Peshawar is.
Yeah.
Yeah, actually, Taliban were only there, and then they used to, you know, target places, different places in Pakistan, but their main hold was in KPK.
I go there tomorrow, Peshawar.
Good luck. No, it's safe. I'm just joking.
Inshallah.
It's safe, I know.
Thank you, brother.
No, this is safe.
Appreciate it.
Thank you very much.
What I thought would be like 30 minutes is maybe like an hour. A couple little technical sections back there. Some nice drops. If you mess up, wow. This is spectacular, guys. Out into a ravine, massive peaks above. And what is that, like are they drilling something? Not sure. But up there you can see some glaciers. And I was told in Hunza, the glaciers are not receding. So it's one of the few parts of the world where the glaciers are not receding. And the valley below, not the whole valley, just actually a small part of it. It's a massive valley. And I was up there yesterday. So, what a place. It's been an amazing adventure. I've tried to pack a lot into a short video. Hopefully some of the lessons I learned, I presented to you. They came across. It's Hunza is a magical part of the world. I've learned a lot. Learned how to chill out a little bit more. And I've seen hospitality in the world. I'm not going to compare, but this is some of the tops. This is, you know, a very giving place. And I think there's a lot to be learned from that. So hope you guys enjoyed it. Tomorrow off to Peshawar. Peshawar is in the far west of the country. Much more conservative from what I've heard. It should be super interesting. So thanks for coming along. Until next one. Like and subscribe if you want to support this channel. Hit the notification bell to be the first to see my next video. Many more videos about Pakistan and other parts of the world coming soon.